Hello, everybody, and welcome to this live webinar where we are going to look at the swimming program here at Swansea University. You will have an opportunity to ask questions, so feel free to put them in the chat box. And we'll try our best to answer as many of those questions as possible. With me today, we've got Hayley Baker, who is the head of the swimming program here at Swansea. And Hayley is going to take you through a quick presentation about the programme and talk to you a little bit about what's going on here at Swansea. And then, like I said, at the end, we can ask some questions. So I will hand you over now to Hayley to take you through the presentation. So here we go. Thanks, Hayley.
Thanks, Roger. Well, welcome to everybody who's been able to make it today. So this is just a short presentation about the swim team. And I'm going to start with a little video that shows you some of the competitions and a little bit of the lifestyle that can be had when you are here. So to go into a little bit more detail, hopefully you might have recognised a few faces on that film, and we can talk about that as we go through. But within the club, we have a five-tier structure. So we start where we have a development, competitive, a performance, a high performance, and then we're fortunate enough to also be in close working relationships with Swim Wales. So we also have contact with the Swim Wales High Performance Squad. To go into a little bit of detail about the coaching team. So you've got myself as head coach. You've got Andy HT, who is normally about on poolside. He's the assistant. And then you also have the Swim Wales staff, as you see at the bottom. So the pictures that aren't on there are of our S&C coaches that work solely with the university team. Unfortunately, they were a little bit shy, so I haven't got pictures of them today. So our development squad. So this is the squad that if perhaps you haven't swam for a while, you want to get back into doing a little bit of training, or maybe you want a good university life balance, perhaps, shall I say, then this is probably a squad that you quite like. So there's four coach sessions per week. It's a combination of long course and short course training. We also have two strength and conditioning sessions available. And we have the opportunity for you to compete in the National University Development League, so the NUDL. Okay, that's quite a new league that's just been set up. And that just helps us get a little bit of our team spirit going. So you don't have to be able to be amazing, but it's really good for you to get involved with the team on that. And you also get the opportunity to compete in local competitions if you want to, but there isn't any pressure. And if you don't want to compete at all, that's fine. You can just turn up, train, and join in the socials. The next squad up is the competitive squad, and they have 7 sessions. Again, long and short, you have 2 strength and conditioning sessions. And with this, as well as the NUDL team, you also get the opportunity to be picked for varsity and also to be picked for some of the books, team and individual events, as well as the normal competitions that you can do. So that just gives you a little bit of an increase in competition. Varsity is a really good competition to be part of. And as the Swansea University team, we are the present winners and we will be continuing that trend. So it would be great to have as many people part of that as possible. Now, for those of you that are interested in more of a performance lifestyle, we've got 2 performance squads. The first one we have where we've got 8 coach swim sessions. It's an individual program. So whereas you might have a generic program a bit lower down, this is where we start to look at actually what your events are and what you need. So there'll be an individual program given to you. We look at doing some spin bike sessions as well as some strength and conditioning sessions. And the usual competitions, so you've got varsity, and then you could be picked for the USL. Okay, so that's a university swim league. And for that, it's actually the top 8 teams in Bucks. They're selected to go against each other head to head throughout the year. So although we go to Bucks as well, we also try and make sure that we consistently challenge each other with those other universities in the USL. And even though we have just had COVID, we actually did extremely well and beat a lot of our fellow universities, which is looking good for Bucks next year. So you also then get Bucks and local meets and away competition and camp. So we do go away and do some competitions around England and Scotland. And we do look into doing some camps abroad. Obviously, that is with travel permits allowed. And then the high performance university squad. Now, this one is solely coached by me. Andy is also there on most of these sessions to help. And we go from 8 sessions to 10 sessions. And then everything very similar. So you get the opportunity to be in the Bucks, the USL. You get more strength and conditioning, and this is by an individual program. So this is where you will get to go to our beloved shed. It is better than it sounds, I can promise you. But it is a great gym facility, and you will be there with an S&C coach that will work with you on a one-to-one basis or in a group setting, depending. And again, we do our meets, local and away, and our swim camps. We do have the ability to kind of work with some of the local clubs, so that also helps us in maintaining our ability to travel effectively. And then for those of you that are perhaps interested and are at the ability level to go to the Swim Wales High Performance Squad, their sessions are very similar to what we have in the amount. But it is just a smaller coach swimmer ratio. And there are particularly times to get into the Swim Wales High Performance Centre, and they can be emailed out to anybody who's interested. And you do have to, for all the groups, you do have to apply each year. It is quite a competitive program to be part of. So on any of the performance squads, whether it's be the university or the Swim Wales, there is an application form that gets sent out to you, and then you can apply. And then we hold mini interviews, nothing too stressful, but we just want to know a little bit about you, because it's not just about what we can give you. It's also what you bring to the team. And when you're moving into those high performance levels, that's what it's all about. That's the next stage in your development. Moving on to what else you can have while you are at the university. So the additional high performance support that you get. So yes, you get the strength and conditioning, but there's also the option for the scholarship program, We have specific swimming accommodation that does need to be emailed to me before the end of March, if that's something that you are looking for, because I have to coordinate with the accommodation team, and you do have to have us as our first choice. Okay, so for those of you that are thinking, oh, I might, may or may not choose Swansea, if you're looking for specific swimming accommodation, we're able to provide it, but you do have to have us as our first choice. We're also able to organise physiotherapists, sports massage. We've got sports scientists that analyse at competitions and during training sessions. And for those of you that have been to the national pool where you'll be based, we have a massive TV screen there so that we can have some really good interaction around an immediate look at some of your sessions and some of your strokes, which is, I think, vital for the development of you as you as you're getting older. We also have lifestyle support. Yeah, and that's including access to psychologists. And that can be not just about that you're struggling in something to do with swimming. We like to look after you as a holistic athlete. So it's not just about you being part of the swim team. We want you to flourish and thrive within the university setting. And when I think you first come to university, I always say that you see all the freshers and they're bright-eyed and bushy-tailed, and then in a week, you're all panicking and feeling overwhelmed. Okay, so that's where communication comes in, and that's where we've got people that can help you and teammates that have been through it. And that's part of what you get when you come to us. We support all of you, not just you swimming. If you have any email, if you want to email me, then that's my email on there. So contact me with any questions. Obviously, feel free to ask them now, but if anybody doesn't want to, send me an email and I will get back to you as soon as I can with all the information. So, any questions?
Thanks, Hayley. That's a fantastic insight, really, into the programme at Swansea University. And it really is, you know, a fantastic, fantastic programme and, you know, amazing facilities to go along with it. So, you know, just with that, you know, can you mention some names that have come through the programme and, you know, maybe during your time or even before your time?
Yeah, well, we've been lucky enough that we've had both para and able-bodied swimmers. So we've had Ellie Simmons come through the programme. I think she's probably a name that most people recognise. And we've also had Alex Rosser. He went to Commonwealth Games for us. And then on able-bodied side, I think our most famous one at the moment is Alice Thomas. She's on her way to the Olympics. But we have a range of athletes that have been to European juniors, Europeans. So there is a pathway for everybody. So that might feel a bit daunting, thinking, I don't really want to be that Olympian. And that's fine. There's other pathways for you. But if that is your pathway, then we can certainly provide that for you.
Yeah, I think that's the key message, really, is that there's a pathway all the way through, from social all the way through to you know, Olympic athletes. And you know, Jazz Carling as well, and Georgia Davis have also, I think, trained at the pool as well. So some big names that have come through the system. Thank you, everyone, for sending through your questions. We've got a number of questions that have come through. I think you've covered some of them, Hayley, within the presentation, but I will just fire some of these at you if that's okay. And so we've got one here from Chloe. I'm going to be studying on the Bay campus. How do swimmers normally get to and from the pool?
Okay. You do need to think about perhaps what group you're going to go into as to where you're going to book your accommodation. If you're going to be living on Bay, there are buses that help you travel to and from. That's absolutely fine. Or if you decide to go at Singleton, then again, there's buses from morning training, if you go to it, to Bay campus. If you're on the scholarship program, you can get car park passes. They're like gold dust, I will say, very sought after. So I wouldn't overly rely on them, because parking is a bit of a bun fight, to be honest. So I think buses is probably your best bet. Or you can cycle. It's a long way, but you could.
Thanks, Hayley. I think this one here from Jay kind of leads on to it. I think you've mentioned this already, but do you offer sports scholarships?
Yes, we do. And what I should have maybe mentioned is that for our Swimwell's High Performance, the University High Performance, and the Performance Squad. We're all interlinked via times. So they're worked out from the world 16, top 16 times, and then a percentage for each group so that there is an interlink. And the scholarship times are set around the High Performance Swimwell Centre. Now, that doesn't mean that that's an immediate yes or no. It's a two-tier system. There's a gold and a silver, or sort of talented athlete sort of system. And what we do is you can apply to that via the scholarship email, which will be on the website. There's an amazing team there, Imelda. She'd be looking after you. And when you apply, she'll send it to me and I can send out those times to everybody. But just be aware, it is a very competitive program to be part of the scholarship. So I think you need to make a decision about coming to the program and not rely necessarily on the scholarship, because it is a high standard to actually receive one.
That's great. I think it's worth mentioning at this point as well, we do have a TAS dual career athlete accreditation as a university. So as a university, we are set up to help elite athletes. So for example, if you've got competitions that clash with exams or assignments, then through the TAS program, we can work with you and your tutors to either move exams or to get extensions on deadlines and so on. And like I said, the program there is fantastic. So again, it's holistic. They will look at nutrition and psychology and everything else as well. So that covers all sports across the university. So the most talented athletes from all sports across the university will be part of that program. But it really does help you have that dual career, so you can carry on with your sport on a high level, but also carry on with your studies, and hopefully neither will suffer. So you can check out TAS and scholarships, like Ailey said, on the website, and there's an email address there. You can drop the guys an email if you've got any specific questions around scholarships. I'm just pulling up some of these questions. So one has come in here from Sasha. I think you may have mentioned this, but what decides which swimming program you go into? Are there any times it would have to achieve to get into the higher group, for example?
There are times to achieve, but we also look at a balanced program across the whole of the season. So, you know, we don't want everybody in that's 100 freestyler, you know, so we do try and balance it out. And we also look at other aspects. So yes, if you've got the time, that's great. But if you haven't got the time and you're close, it's still worth applying, because at least then what you could do is sort of sell yourself to me. So what's your commitment level like? What's your aspirations? Because it is, we all know, swimming's quite cutthroat in that area, but actually, we want to be able to see, well, there might be an element of development for some of you. You know, we all know the story about some of the athletes that have come to university that have just been great club swimmer, and then they've flourished into people that have gone to Europeans and then further on. I mean, our Alice Thomas is one of those people. So, you know, it's really important that you do that. And if you don't want to do that, then you've got our development and our competitive, where you come along and have an assessment, and then we judge you from there and have a chat and see what you fancy doing, so that we work out what's best for you. You know, don't feel that at any point there's anything that is out of your reach. So make sure it's there for you.
Great. Charlie's asking on accommodation. I think we've covered that. But, you know, we are fortunate to have the ability to have a swimming block on the Singleton campus, which is, you know, a 2-minute walk away from the national pool. And like I said, it takes a little bit of organising ahead of time, but as long as we're organised, we can get all that sorted. And yeah, that is brilliant. It's a short walk across, especially for those early morning sessions. what else have we got? We got one here from Freddie. I think you may have mentioned this, but training hours for each squad, I think that's covered within within the presentation. So you can always go back and rewind and find that information.
I think with those guys, just remember that they're the maximum amount of hours that are available for each of those squads. You may not need to do that depending on what event that you are planning to do. So, you know, just be aware that, again, I think it's a theme that communication with me when you get here is really important to find out what actually you need to do. So, yeah, but yeah, it's all in the presentation that hopefully you can have a look at.
One here from Josh. Do you do event specific training?
Yes. Within the performance, that's exactly what happens. And that follows through to not just what's happening in the pool, but also your S&C. So there is no point in us working on getting you all muscled up if you're a distance swimmer. And equally, there's no point giving you a load of power if you're going to be our distance swimmer. So we look at it and we work across all of the coaches and support staff to enable that. So yes, it is definitely event specific, and there's the ability to mix that up when you get here, but you do tend to then have training partners in certain events, which is always good, especially if we do a bit of head-to-head training.
Yeah, fantastic. I think we come to the end of the questions. So thanks for all the questions. Very, very engaging. Lots of great questions in here. Last one here from Jacob. Is there the ability to move between the training groups?
Yeah, absolutely. It's really important for you to know that wherever you might start, you can move up. And equally, if you're finding things difficult in a higher group, that actually you can move to a different group where you can just maybe set your mind at ease a little bit. And there is no set time at when that move has to happen. So that is available all the way through. The only moves that are perhaps yearly are the movements from my Swansea Uni High Performance Centre to the Swim Wales High Performance Centre. They are annual. But again, that can happen. So we all work closely together. So enjoy moving about and deciding where you fit best, I think, is the key.
Yeah, I think that kind of resonates with, you know, our approach as a university sport for all. You know, so like we've mentioned at the start, there's opportunities there all the way from social to high performance. And there's also the pathway there as well, you know, to start off. And if you want to increase your training, you know, when you're doing well, then you will have that opportunity to move up and to experience, you know, a higher level of competition. So I think that kind of brings us to a close. That thank you, Hayley, for your time this morning. It's been really fascinating to hear, you know, a little bit more about the program. And like I said, I can't reiterate enough how great, you know, the program is, and the coaches really make that program. So thanks to you and the team there. As Hayley's mentioned, the email address is there, hayley.baker@swansea.ac.uk. We've also got the webpage as well, so there's a video on there. You can have a look at what the program is like, and it'll give you a bit more of an idea of what life is like at Swansea. So I think that kind of wraps it up. Unless there's anything else, Hayley, I think we'll press stop record and
I just think, yep, my last word is get in contact. We do allow you to come down and visit us and actually get in and train with us. So if you're about and you want to do that, then please let me know, because sometimes it's better to come and experience us, and that's what we're more than happy to help provide. So hopefully we'll see you soon.
Fantastic. Thank you for having us, that's managed to join us today. Thank you. Hopefully we'll be able to see you in person very soon. Thanks all. Bye-bye.